EVS, Family Functions and Festivals. This is a activity based chapter, so no explanation is required. I will be showing you the pictures of family functions and our festivals, and I will be giving you some information about it. These informations you already know, yes or no? So it is a very easy chapter for the exam, for the online exam. If it is an online exam, teachers will be giving you pictures and you have to identify the festivals and family functions. Okay, so let us begin. Family functions and festivals. Why family functions and festivals are important? See, family functions and festivals always bring joy, happiness and fun in the family environment. Yes or no? It is a place or it is a celebration where the entire family get together to enjoy an event which bring lot of fun, which brings lot of joy and happiness. So, family functions and festivals are really very important in one's life, because it is a get together of each and every family member at one place. Yes or no, students? Yes. Now let us see which functions come under family functions. Which functions come under family functions? They are naming ceremony. What it is? Naming ceremony, birthdays, pujas and wedding functions. I will repeat again. Naming ceremony, birthdays, pujas and wedding functions. These 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 functions usually or mainly come under family function. We will be seeing each and every function in detail. I will be showing you the image as well as I will be giving you the information. You know about it, but still I will be giving you the information. First one, naming ceremony. Now, what is a naming ceremony? When a baby is born in the family, naming ceremony is arranged. Naming ceremony is organized. Yes or no? The entire family, including friends and well-wishers, are called to bless the occasion, to grace the occasion. Yes or no, students? Yes, you may have attended anyone. In the naming ceremony, the newborn baby is given a name. Yes? Yes. Sweets and snacks are distributed to everyone in this ceremony. Yes or no? So, naming ceremony comes under family function. If you have not attended, once you can attend this. So, next let us see birthdays. Now, birthdays are celebrated by many people. Even you celebrate your birthday. Yes or no? So, what you do on your birthday? Family members and friends are invited to share this special occasion. They come to your home and they also grace this occasion. Yes or no, students? People decorate their house, prepare snacks and order cake. And on that cake, your name is mentioned. Yes or no? And order cake for everyone to enjoy. Then the cake is cut by singing happy birthday to you. Yes or no? So birthday comes under family function. Birthday is very important for all of us. Yes or no, students? Yes. Next, pujas. Many people occasionally offer special prayers in worship of God and invite their families and friends, neighbors, to pray with them and be blessed by God. So, puja is also a family function. Puja also comes under family function. So, puja is important at our house for finance and peace. Lastly, we are going to see wedding functions. When someone in the family gets married, many functions takes place like mehndi ceremony, then wedding ceremony and finally reception. The entire family takes part in all the wedding functions and helps in the preparations. We really enjoy weddings. Yes or no, students? So the entire family participates in the function and blesses the newly married couple. Newly married couple gets lots of blessings as well as gifts. Cash in hand and many other pretty presents. Yes or no? So, 4 functions I have mentioned here under family functions. They are naming ceremony, birthdays, pujas and wedding function. So I hope family function is clear to you. Let us see national festivals. National festivals are very important part of our Indian culture. Yes or no? Yes. Why? Because these festivals are held in the memory of many important events in Indian history. Now you are in second standard. When you will go to fourth standard, you will have EVS 1, and in that EVS 1 and EVS 2. So in EVS 2, you will be learning about Maharashtra history, as well as in the coming years, that is in 5th, 6th, 7th till 10th, you will be learning about Indian history. So on these days, we salute our Indian flag. We honor our soldiers, patriots and martyrs, and remember them for the bravery and loyalty to our country. So name the two national festivals: Independence Day and Republic Day. Yes, correct. Let us see Independence Day. India achieved independence from the British rule. British ruled India for 200 years. So we got independence from them on 15th of August 1947. Every year on this day, the entire country celebrates by hoisting the tricolor national flag. Even schools are decorated. Teachers and students are supposed to come on this day. We don't have holidays on Independence Day and Republic Day. It is a working day. Why we have to come to school? To celebrate our Independence Day. Yes or no? We hoist the tricolor national flag. Who hoist? Either the principal or the committee member or someone very famous in that area or in that place. After hoisting the national flag, we sing the national anthem, Jana Gana Mana. Yes or no? Then programs are organized. Many peer students sing patriotic songs, some gives speeches. Yes or no? Some act is shown, some dramas related to Independence Day. Yes or no? In this way, we enjoy the Independence Day. Likewise, even Republic Day, on 26th of January 1950, India was declared as a republic. On this day, our own constitution was adopted. Yes, hence every year this day is celebrated as Independence Day. So on this day, even the national flag is hoisted in schools, offices and other institutions. Everybody gets the holiday, but teacher and students are supposed to come to school. The flag is hoisted at school, and even the flag is hoisted at Delhi. Their national parade also takes place. So two important festivals I have mentioned here, they are Independence Day and Republic Day. So Independence Day and Republic Day comes under national festival. So I hope national festival is clear to you. Let us see religious festival. There are many religious festival. On these festival we get lot of holidays, either 1 day holiday, 2 days holiday, 3 days holiday, 5 days holiday, 7 days holiday, even we get 10 days holiday for the Christmas. Yes, children, this month we have Christmas holidays for 10 days, then Diwali vacation of 18 days. So teacher and students eagerly wait when the new month begin. We always check the calendar to see whether we are getting any holidays for any religious festival. Let us see the first religious festival, Gudi Padwa. Gudi Padwa is the first day of the year of the Hindu calendar. People celebrate this day by hoisting gudis in front of their home and worshipping. Next one, Gokul Ashtami. Gokul Ashtami is celebrated as the birthday of Lord Krishna. People worship Lord Krishna on this day and distribute sweets to members, relatives and family friends. On the second day, processions are taken out in which people of all ages participate. They go from one place to another by singing Govinda Ala Re Ala and breaking Dahi Handis. Yes or no, students? We enjoy this day as well. But we get holiday only for 1 day. But Gokul Ashtami is celebrated for 2 days. The first day we observe fasting because Lord Krishna was also born in the midnight. Yes or no? And the next day we break the Dahi Handis. Next one, Ganesh Chaturthi. Ganesh Chaturthi or Ganeshotsav is celebrated for 11 days. Many people bring the idol of Lord Ganesh to their homes and keep it for a day and half, or 5 days, 7 days, 10 days, or 11 days. Every day, puja and aarti are offered. Ganesh ji's favorite sweet, the modak, is distributed among everyone. We get lot of modaks these days. Yes or no? Ganesh Utsav is also celebrated on a large scale in public. Entertainment programs are organized and many people go to offer prayers to Lord Ganesh. On Anant Chaturdashi day, we get holiday. Usually, we get holiday for 10 days. Yes or no? But sometimes, if we get holiday for 1 or 3 days, we get holiday on Anant Chaturdashi as well. So, on Anant Chaturdashi, which is the last day of the Ganesh Utsav, people gather in big processions to immerse the Ganesh idol and wish for his early return the next year. Yes or no? While we immerse the Ganpati Bappa, what do we say? Ganpati Bappa, next year, please come early. Yes or no? And next one, Diwali. Diwali is the festival of lights. Yes, everybody know. It is celebrated for 4 days. People decorate their houses with lights and draw rangolis in front of their houses. Lanterns of different colors are hung outside the house. New clothes are brought and people share sweets with each other. Yes, children burn crackers, they wear new clothes. Yes or no? The next day there is a Lakshmi Pujan. People worship the goddess Lakshmi, goddess of wealth. The last day is Bhau Beej. On this day, the sister prayers for the long life of her brother. Gifts are exchanged and there is happiness all around. Everybody waits for Diwali festival. Yes or no? It is a long festival. After the summer vacation, we get 18 to 20 days holiday for school. Yes or no, students? So, Diwali is a favorite festival. Next one, Holi. Holi is celebrated on the day of Falgun Purnima. It is the festival of colors. On this day, leftover of squeezed sugarcane, grass, wood and dry cow dung cakes are set on fire. It is the symbolic of getting rid of all the cruel and evil. A sweet dish called Puran Pori is prepared on this day. Wow! The holy fire is set in the evening or at night according to the Muhurat. There is a time for this to set the fire. People sing songs and dance around the fire. The next day is known as Dhuli Vandan. So again, Holi is a two-day festival. Very first day, we observe fast and we lit this fire. Yes or no? We lit the Holika. And on the next day, Holi of colors is celebrated. Yes or no, students? Next one, Ramzan. The festival of Ramzan and Eid is celebrated by the Muslim community. They fast for the entire month of Ramzan and celebrate Eid on the last day of the month when they see the full moon. They pray in mosque after the namaz and they wish each other Eid Mubarak Ho and they prepare delicious snacks, delicious food, kheer, everything at their home and they enjoy Ramzan along with their family and friends. Yes or no, students? Yes. Every festival is important for us. Why? Because we get lot of holidays on religious festival. Yes or no, students? Yes. Teachers and students are so lucky regarding holidays. Yes or no, students? Yes. Next one, Raksha Bandhan. Raksha Bandhan celebrates the bond between a brother and a sister. The sister ties a rakhi on her brother's wrist and prays for his well-being. The brother in turn gives his sister gifts and promises to protect her and take good care of her. Even at school, rakhi celebration is done. Girls bring rakhi and boys bring some pencil, rubber, cutter, anything as a token of love to them. Next one, Samvatsari. This is an important festival of the Jain community. It is celebrated for 9 days. Some people fast for the first 8 days and they break their fast on the 9th day. Processions are organized and people wish each other good health and happiness. How they wish? Michchami Dukkadam. Even our Prime Minister of India, he wishes us. Have you ever heard from him? Yes. Next one, Buddha Purnima. Buddha Purnima is celebrated as the birthday of Gautam Buddha. Gautam Buddha founded a religion called Buddhism. This festival is celebrated by the followers of this religion. Yes, students, even on Buddha Purnima, we get holiday for school. Yes or no, students? Yes. Every festival is important because we get holiday. Next one, Guru Nanak Jayanti. Guru Nanak is the founder of the Sikh religion, Sikh community. The Sikhs celebrate Guru Nanak Jayanti, which is Guru Nanak's birthday, birth anniversary. They pray in Gurdwaras, feed poor people and organize langars. Have you ever visited Amritsar's Golden Temple? Yes. Next one, Christmas. Jesus Christ founded Christianity. Christmas is celebrated on the 25th of December, the day Lord Jesus was born. Many Christians go to church and offer prayers one night before and celebrate Christmas. The festival of Christmas lasts for 7 days. Yes, we get holiday from 24th of December till 1st January. Yippee! It ends on the 1st of January, which is New Year's Day. People all over the world celebrate Christmas and New Year with great enthusiasm, happiness and excitement. During Christmas, many people light up and decorate their houses with banners, streamers and most important of all, a Christmas tree is seen in everybody's house. Yes or no, students? Yes. It is under this Christmas tree that Santa Claus leaves gifts for children on Christmas Eve. Yes, we are eagerly waiting for Christmas. Yes or no, students? Yes. So, let us see the next festival. Pateti. The Parsi community celebrates Pateti. Pateti is also known as Parsi New Year. On this day, the Parsis go to the fire temple or Agyari. Why it is known as fire temple? Because a fire is always burning. You can see a fire when you go to Parsi's religious place. So it is known as fire temple. Last one, Dasera or also called as Dashera. On this day, Lord Ram defeated Ravan in Lanka and gained victory over all evils. A model of Ravan is burnt, signifying destruction of all evils. Look into the image above. This day is also known as Vijayadashmi. In schools, goddess Saraswati, the goddess of knowledge, is worshipped. Yes, correct. We do an activity on this. People visit each other and exchange leaves of the Apta tree as a token of gold and wish each other happiness. We give this leaf by saying Sona. Yes or no? We give Sona and we say Happy Dashera. So students, I hope you enjoyed this chapter. It is an activity-based chapter. You can stick any 5 pictures of religious festival and 2 pictures of national festival in your scrapbook. Thank you.